Thank you. I will have a brief presentation about a long project in a very short time. It has not started, but I think it is of interest because this kind of project we started first of September, will basically define what we are going to do for a long time in the future. It's kind of a platform for research within a certain technology area, and it will go on for 8 years. That's kind of unusual in research. So within this framework, we will launch a number of projects over the years because we don't really know what the future technology will take us and what our result will take us. So we call it the Next Generation Industrial IoT, NEAT. And I will first describe within what technology areas we are working in this project. So I think we got a great introduction both from Rice and from Michele about issues when it comes to industrial IoT. The straightforward model for IoT is like you have lots of devices send the data up to the cloud, and then there's storage processing, and then the result is fed back. But as you heard, we have a problem with that approach. Industrial applications have quite high requirements on latency. You want to have fast response time. So you have to manage that in some way. And we heard from Michele that the extreme way, you basically do it right at the sensor source. So one have to find other approaches. And the natural approach is to see how should the computation in your system be done, if it should be locally in the sensor, a little bit higher up, or in the cloud. It depends on the requirements. So latency is one thing, energy is another thing. If you want to have your sensor device, for example, connected directly to cloud, and it's a wireless device, you will not have a battery lifetime at all. But the distributed computing is one topic in this. Where should the computation take place? It's not obvious. It's application dependent, and to develop methods to handle this. The situation gets worse if we believe that most of the devices will be wirelessly connected, because it's very convenient, of course, to get rid of the wires, installation costs, and so on. But we have a worse communication channel, not reliable as wired communication, for example. And we have capacity problem. And wireless connectivity is more scalable than wired, because of mainly of the insulation issues of wired communication. Then you have the devices. If you want to observe and control your processes in detail, you have to be able to observe more things in the process and control more things in your process. The number of devices is likely to be increased then, because if you can sense more and have more actuation and control, then you can run the processes in more efficient way. More devices, wireless connected, maybe you want to do some local processing, you have a battery problem. And if you have a process line with thousands of devices, sensor devices, it will be a maintenance issue replacing batteries. And that is hardly acceptable to maybe sometimes stop the process to change the battery. So the end devices, sensors, and on the lowest level, you want to have the devices as autonomous as possible. Energy autonomous, not to rely on battery, for example. And also, when it comes to functions, that it can do as much processing and self-calibration or whatever. So you don't have to micromanage your system with all the devices. So the area we are going to work in is dependable wireless connectivity, autonomous devices, and distributed data analysis. So this is the short version of the motivation. So for wireless communication, there are certain things that comes with wireless communication that distinguish it from wired. Reliability, security, deterministic communication. Latency is one thing, but if you cannot rely on, you don't know, there's a big variation between data packets coming, then it's a problem in many control systems. And communication is constrained by energy. So many things comes out, but you have limited energy resources. And autonomous sensor, if we want to be energy autonomous, not rely on battery, one can look at, we are going to look at, and we are working on it, energy harvesting. So the devices extract, convert energy of some form, vibration, whatever, to electrical energy that could power the devices. And then we have the household with the energy, find good ways to execute functions in an energy efficient way. So, and distributed computing also related to latency issues, energy consumption issues. So these are not only separate tracks, but they are highly related to each other. So we have a roadmap for research, not a complete plan, because the end date is 2027. So things will happen. We have, of course, a plan for coming years. Important for us is to be connected to international research environments. So we are recruiting international guest professors, postdocs, and of course, PhD students to work in the project. We will also develop our master and PhD programs, the educational side of the research. So these are highly connected. And with our industrial partners, we will apply our research result to specific applications. So this is neat in summary. These are our partners, industrial partners. They come from a wide range of businesses. You have communication, Telia, Lumen Radio Communication, then you have all kinds of industrial companies, HIA, Bosch, and so on. So, in brief, this is neat.